The difference between being a purely analytical space and a space where we're prototyping, we're building things, we're creating tools. Hopefully we can have a bit of a positive influence on the cultural meaning of technology and how we take that forward.
A lot of research, you can have the idea and then you've got to do lots of other steps to try and then say, well, okay, how am I going to do it? I've got to get my hands on this equipment or this expertise. In this environment, you've got that expertise probably sitting at the desk next to you. You've got people who are into the tech and also into the creative, playful side of things.
This is all about exploring the truth in a different way. We work together and we share an idea.
The idea of SensiLab really came about in response to the way that technology was changing research. Having the technological and scientific tools enable you to do something, but the thing that's fundamentally driving you is creative expression, human expression.
When artists have a say in the tools that they're creating, I try to think about from the perspective of being a musician and what I would like to use or what I would like to see, and use that as the starting point for then designing artificial intelligence to create music in new ways. I think there's a role for AI to shape that communication without taking the people out of it.
SensiLab's been instrumental to all our latest work. At a place like Monash, there's all kinds of new possibilities you can explore with these technologies, which are not the obvious ones.
Got a phone call saying there's a big new lab opening up over in Australia. It's going to be full of creative people doing amazing research. It's very well equipped in a top university. And then that's all she could tell me until I'd kind of, you know, taken the bait.
My project is basically looking at affective computing and how it aligns or doesn't align with modern theories of emotion. But I'm also looking into kind of creative AI applications and how we can use affective information to enhance co-creation between human and AI.
I'm making a VR project, so I need a lot of people to help, to be honest. A lot of technicians and scientists and designer, they all have a different skill, different perspective. Really nurturing environment, I reckon.
This is really a place where people make things and then reflect on it, and there's some great connections to not only researchers but also artists. It's a really great place to collaborate and interact.
Being able to combine those two things together was really important for the creative practice that I have, and I think it sort of underpins a lot of the ethos of the lab that we work in. Technology is interesting, technology is important, but it's fundamentally about bigger ideas than just the technology itself.
Creating this new space that doesn't actually exist anywhere else to do these types of research that kind of on the forefront of new research. I think if I was going to do my PhD on the same topic, there would be very few places where I could do that.
I wanted to create an environment where people from many different disciplines could come together and feel at home. It's about bringing people together in an environment that stimulates their creativity.